Welcome to Philosophy 4 at Las Positas College. This is an introductory lecture on Aristotle's theory of knowledge and his differences from Plato. Aristotle was the student of Plato. He entered Plato's academy at 18 years old, and he studied under Plato for 20 years before founding his own school called the Lyceum in ancient Athens. Aristotle's ideas show a strong influence from Plato's thought, but he also argues directly against Plato's ideas in some of his writings. We have seen that for Plato, the world in which we live is just a shadow of reality. Things in the physical world only distantly approach the perfect and eternal things that exist in the heavenly realm of the forms. To find knowledge, our goal is to get beyond the illusions cast by this world and to attune our minds to the eternal truths which exist outside of our world. True justice and equality, even the true chair and horse, are eternal ideas which have always existed and would have existed whether or not humans, horses, and chairs had ever existed on earth. It is awareness of these forms for Plato which counts as knowledge. So think back to something like Plato's idea of the horse. For Plato, whether or not horses had ever existed, the idea of the horse is eternal, and a horse on earth, though never the perfect idea of a horse, becomes a horse by partially embodying that eternal idea. Embodying that idea is what makes the horse what it is. And true knowledge is when we look beyond the physical horse in the world to understand the idea of horse. Same would be said for Plato of justice. There's poor examples of partial justice on earth, so we can only learn the idea of true justice by looking beyond earth and up to the eternal idea, which exists outside of any human experience, outside of the physical world, as the perfect idea of justice. For Aristotle, on the other hand, something like a triangle is just the form that earthly triangles and earthly things take to be in the shape of a triangle. The form of a person, or the form human, is just something that exists within matter in the shape of a human, just like the form of the horse. There's no separate realm of ideas. There's no idea that exists separate from being embodied within matter. And so for Aristotle, this entire realm of being is no longer necessary or real. This means that for Plato, we obtain knowledge by overcoming the allure of the half-real physical world and getting to know the eternal world of forms. For Aristotle, our world is real and is a source of knowledge. The forms give order to the world, and forms never exist apart from the physical world. How is knowledge of abstract and general things like horse, triangle, and the good possible? Plato's answer: you can never get knowledge of true forms from earthly observation. You must already have known about them from another life beyond this earth. For Aristotle, our intuitive faculty forms a general idea of a horse, a triangle, or a face by observing many particular horses, triangles, or faces. So in the case of scientific knowledge about the form of the human body, we learn by studying the human body, and the form of the body is generalized from that experience. This epistemological difference is also heavily reflected in Aristotle's ethics. You remember from our quick survey of Plato's Symposium that he believes humans start out with their desires and aspirations mixed up with their human circumstances, but that eventually we should realize that both beauty and ethical truth lie beyond our world. Changing our focus from our relationships with others and onto eternal truth is the only way to find virtue. That is why Raphael, in his famous painting, has Plato pointing up toward heaven. In contrast, Raphael has Aristotle with his hand motioning down to earth, indicating that we can learn from studying the world itself. In the case of ethics, Aristotle starts by saying that the honest person must accept that ethical rules are only imperfect generalizations of what is good for humans, because we learn virtue from observation here on earth. We gradually learn the nature of ethics by studying our experiences and learning what makes life for humans fulfilling and well-lived. This is one reason why Aristotle encourages us to find virtuous models of the good life here on earth, people who can exemplify what the good life looks like. Even without a virtuous model, we can learn new ethical truth by studying our own experiences and learning what is right or wrong, both for me as a human and as an individual. Aristotle's arguments against Plato's forms. In the Metaphysics, Aristotle says it is ultimately impossible to explain how eternal and transcendent forms could participate with physical things. Aristotle claims that this metaphor does not provide a real explanation of things here on earth. In a similar way, he points out that if you want to explain things that exist in our world by postulating many more things that exist outside of our world, you haven't really made progress. The existence of the forms themselves cannot be explained, so how can they explain the things that we experience on earth? Aristotle also asked the reader why, on Plato's view of the forms, there is ever change on earth. If the true reality is made up of always present, timeless, and unchanging forms, what causes change here on earth? As we will see when we cover modern philosophy, starting in a few weeks, all of these claims by Aristotle have led to him being referred to as the father of empiricism. Empiricism is the general movement in philosophy that starts from the claim that anything we learn on earth must have been learned from our experience here, in the real world, with observation, using our human senses in a process of learning. By contrast with this, Plato is referred to as the father of idealism. Idealists will continually point out that nothing could be experienced for us unless we took the blooming, buzzing confusion of the senses and organized it with principles that we bring to experience that cannot be learned from observation alone.